Okay, so let's go ahead and examine you. We're just going to test a few things. I'm Dr. Nath, and I'm a neurologist interested in trying to understand how ALS progresses and if there are novel ways in which we can treat the disease.
Ever since being diagnosed in January of 14, I kind of made it a mission of mine to find out as much as I can. What's available out there is treatments, trials, and just my way of giving back, whether it helps me directly or somebody comes after me. I think it's important to donate scientific data, bio data, to doctors so they can do their research.
What we recently showed was that in patients with ALS, there's a virus that is incorporated into the human genome that can get activated. And so we are, and although we found that activated in the brains of patients, what we are very interested in is trying to develop assays whereby we can measure it either in the blood or in the spinal fluid. And so that's the purpose of this study. Tell me a little bit about your exercise history. So have you been very active throughout your life?
Yeah.
What kinds of sports?
Well, when I was in high school, I played football.
Okay.
Wrestled. I'm from Long Island, New York. I've been kind of active and athletic my whole life. And, you know, minor aches and pains, and even bilateral knee replacements didn't slow me down. Even after that, I went back to skiing, working out. So how did it affect me? You know, 3 years ago, I slowed down dramatically. And now I can't do any of those things. I can't ski, obviously. Can't work out. I rode a bike last summer. That was pretty dangerous for me. So my life has changed a lot. But in some ways, I feel fortunate and lucky because while I was diagnosed 2 years ago, a little over 2 years ago, I could have died of a heart attack or stroke and not had time to. Well, this should be the happy part. You know, meet with old friends, you know, strengthen family ties, travel.
It's a tough disease. You know? And he's done a great job handling it. Yeah, done a remarkable job, really. Yeah. Mr. Michael has been a volunteer in our study, and he has graciously agreed to participate in this study, knowing fully well that at the moment we may not have a treatment for it, but he's willing to donate samples and his time for the purpose of us trying to understand the pathophysiology of the disease, and with the hope that we may have some biomarker that we can monitor for treatment in the future.